So Adobe's just integrated Nano Banana into Photoshop Beta. Check it out right now and then come back at the end and I'll give you my thoughts on this. So maybe you've heard of Nano Banana. Now it's in Photoshop and it's able to turn this into this. I'm going to show you a number of examples. I'm going to show you how to activate it, how to use it. I've also got some tips, and I'm even going to show you how to combine images in it. The first thing you need to know is it's only available inside Photoshop Beta right now. So if we go to the Creative Cloud, click on Apps, you'll see Beta, download the Photoshop Beta. Okay, so in order to activate it, what you need to do is you need to make a selection. So why don't we select the subject, which is going to be this woman, and we're going to inverse it. So you can inverse it by clicking up there or choosing Command-Shift-I. I just chose Invert Selection from the contextual taskbar. So now you're going to hit Generative Fill. And this is just like working in Firefly with Generative Fill. However, we can change the models. And if we see FI, click on here, and you'll notice that we have Nano Banana, which is Gemini 2.5 made by Google. Now it's activated here, and now we can use Gemini 2.5 or Nano Banana. So let's change the background to a futuristic space scene. All right, let's do a futuristic city from the year 3000. And here we have a city. Now you'll notice the quality, in my opinion, is much better than what you're getting from Firefly. But what makes Nano Banana special is the way it can preserve detail. So we could preserve this person and do different things. So right now she's clearly not dressed for that year. So why don't we grab the selection brush here, and we're going to use the, you'll see it under the lasso, the selection brush, and then we're going to paint over, in fact, let's make this much bigger. We're going to paint over all her clothes. And why don't we change this to something a little bit more futuristic? So we're just grabbing all of this. And don't worry about going over, because the areas we go over are going to be, they're just going to be fine. So let's change her outfit to a, so let's change it to futuristic space jacket. And notice we have the jacket, and it pretty much preserved her. If we want to look before and after, look at that. Didn't even really change your hair. But maybe we want to change your hair. So why don't we just make a selection around your hair. And let's just grab it all. And so one of the advantages in using Nano Banana in Photoshop is the ability to make these selections. And let's change the hair to something a little bit more futuristic. And there we go. So the only other thing is this tablet. Let's change the tablet, make a selection around it, just kind of paint over it roughly. And we're going to change this tablet to something clear glass. Let's change the tablet to clear glass with a glowing UI. Looks like we're missing a finger. So why don't we just see if we can get. Let's give her a cyborg hand. All right, so we've got a cyborg hand. So as you can see, it's able to generate very well. Now, one of the things you might have noticed is the resolution is really low. Things are looking very, very soft. So if we look here, there's her original face and original body. So it hasn't changed that, but some of these other areas you can see are very low. It's only about 1K resolution at the moment. All right, so let's go to something really simple, and I'm going to give you a really powerful tip, and then we're going to move into something even more wild. So why don't we just make a selection here around her hat? And we're just going to choose remove hat. And hit generate. Now, this is the kind of thing that we would do with Firefly. All right, so we removed the hat, and if we zoom in here, we can see it's pretty good, but notice this edge. But the texture doesn't quite match, right? I'm going to show you another way of doing this. So we're going to grab that selection brush again. And by the way, this is a great use case for the selection brush. And we're going to jump in here and we're going to take the hardness. We're going to take it all the way down. And then we're going to adjust this now with a softer edge. And this is the trick. You're going to get much better results now. Watch this. I hope. And there we go, we've removed the hat, and let's zoom in and notice the textures are definitely blending in a lot smoother. Here it is with the hard edge selection. Look at the edge, look at the texture mismatch. And then here we go. There's still a texture mismatch, but as you can see, it just blends a little bit smoother when we're using that soft edge brush. Now it's not perfect. There's little areas there where maybe I didn't brush that correctly. But if we want to see her with the hat, without the hat. So one of the strengths of Nano Banana is being able to reproduce a person and keep their likeness. So why don't we do that right now? Let's select everything. And then we're going to hit on Generator Fill. And let's see what happens if we pan the camera to the right. And notice now we're looking down the same street. If we look at this before, there's the wall, there's the cafe. Look at the types of chairs. There's a croissant and look at the woman. If we look here, the croissant is gone. The tables and chairs are kind of similar. Let's have a look. Yeah. Same table, same chairs, same woman. And just to see how well it does, let's just go back to the woman. And why don't we select just around her? And we'll change her expression. So we want her to look surprised, and we can see if we can keep someone that looks like the same person being surprised. Okay, maybe a little, it's not bad. I wouldn't say that's necessarily the same person, but let's try something else. And with that selection, let's use the selection brush because that soft selection is going to look better. Because as you noticed here, with the hard selection, yeah, it doesn't look good. So let's, I'm going to give it more space because we're going to see if we can get her to turn her head and look the other way and see if it still looks like the same person. Looking at the direction. And there we go. That's pretty wild. And, you know, yeah, it could pass for her. All right, let me show you something else that's quite interesting. And that's if we are here, and let me make a selection around the car. And what we're going to do is we're going to change the color of the car. Let's do something really wild like camo. Change car color to orange and white camo. Let's try this. And there we go. Look at that. Before and after. All right, so let's just take that off for now. And let's combine images and see how this works. All right, so let's choose the background here and we're going to remove the background. And of course, this is a Photoshop feature. And now we've got the car. We're going to drag the car into the water image. And then release. We've dropped it on there. Let's resize it. Control or Command T. Rescale it. Let's resize it. Put the car there. It's just kind of floating above it, right? So why don't we try something here? So let's make a selection around the car. Now, the thing is, because you don't have a lot of resolution, don't do the entire image unless you have to. Give it a little bit of space to work, but, you know, so maybe it can make some ripples or different things like that, but don't make the area too tight. Don't make it too big. So we're going to choose here, and then we're going to put, and we're going to, plain English, put the car in the water a little bit. Let's see what happens. And look at that. It's now in there. It's even got the splashes on the wheels and everything like that. Very impressive. Well, why don't we go a little bit wilder? Let's select the entire scene. So I'm just going to hit Control A. And I'm going to say, okay, so we're going to add rainy, stormy weather with dark clouds and lightning striking the car. And look at that. Okay, we can even go further than that. Yep, believe it or not. Let's select the entire image. What if we decide to go a little bit higher on the scene? Let's change the angle to a drone shot looking from above. And look at that. So one of the advantages in maintaining the objects in the image and the environment is that we've got a continuity where we can start to create stories and storyboards. And what happens if we decide to change this to a comic book? So let's select the whole thing, Control A. So Control A or Command A, and let's change this. Let's change this to a 1950s style comic book. Oh, that's hilarious. We got the crack Zapple. You got some Batman stuff going on here. That's kind of cool. Now, notice though, you only get one variation. So I'm not quite sure I really want that. So let's hit Generate again and see if we can get something. Because it doesn't look super comic book to me. There we go. That's what I was thinking. Looks more like a comic book now. Look at this. Flash smash. Power surge. Oh. So as you can see, Nano Banana is capable of doing some pretty amazing generative AI, kind of along the lines of where Firefly's been going, but I think it's a lot further along and generates a lot better than Firefly. If this is your first time seeing it, maybe you're having a panic attack and you're thinking, oh no, is this the end of Photoshop? Are my skills irrelevant? Is it just replaced with a text prompt? And I would say the answer to that is absolutely no. There's a lot of things it can do and there's a lot of things it can't do. So if you think about your day-to-day tasks that you use Photoshop for, there's a lot of things that we use Photoshop for that are not going to be replaced by this, but then there are some other things where this is going to help us as an assistant, and I just look at it as a tool. It's another tool, it's a very useful tool to have, but it's not going to do everything for you, and even when you generate the images using Nano Banana, you'll still want to have those tools and the skills to go in and manually adjust those and get exactly what you want. And especially when we come into the area of photography. In photography, you want to use your camera, whether it's a big camera, whether it's a small camera, this is your photograph. Most of the time, you're not going to want to replace all of it or even a little piece of it using AI. You might want to make some adjustments to the color, remove some things, you know, do some of your own adjustments. But your skills are still going to come into place. And especially if you're a graphic designer, there's so much you're going to be doing graphic design that this is not doing for you. So I wouldn't panic about it. I wouldn't think this is the end of your career or anything like that. Just treat it as another tool. It's a tool that you're going to use, it's going to help you, assist you, but at the end of the day, you're still in the driver's seat and you're the one still doing the work. Some would say when you're working on your imagery, there's time when you're going to be using the traditional tools in Photoshop, there's times when you're going to be using generative AI, and then there's other times when you're going to be combining both of them together to get the exact result that you're really looking for. So anyway, let us know your thoughts, drop them in the comments underneath. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button so you won't miss any of my tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.